On the off chance that you absolutely need to break a shielder.
Has that ever happened? Ever? Ever in the history of ever?
Yeah, what? Frost Knight, Taker shielders. There you go.
So, the off chance that you happen to get a Taker that you, your teammates, or the four defenders cannot take down, you will be there to fucking do it.
And everybody will say thank you.
You'll be like, guys, this is my moment. This is my moment. Hey guys, what's going on? Rounded Tic Tac here, and today we're finally getting around to the Gamatron 9000, the new assault rifle that you can get from the Llamas. I know you guys desperately want to know how good it is. Assault rifles in general are usually the most popular weapon in the entire game, and I probably should have done this earlier, just I was more interested in other guns because, again, it's just an assault rifle. But how good is it? Well, it's very, very comparable to the Razor Blade. The Razor Blade is a weapon that you can get from the game from day one. You do not need any kind of special treatment or anything. It is available from day one. And I mean, this gun is super similar to it, except it excels in a few areas that we're going to talk about. Lastly, the build, one of the builds I'm going to show you two, one of them is an interesting kind of like hybrid-esque build, something that I tried a few different times and tweaked it till I got to a point where I liked it. Another topic we're going to talk about is burst damage versus sustained damage. Now, if you know anything about the channel, you know that I absolutely love burst weapons, so this one is right up my alley. But if we take a closer look, we'll see exactly how good it is compared to something that you can get from day one. There's not many other burst weapons in the game, so I fear this is a fair comparison. Now, the DPS goes to the Gamatron with the Razor Blade losing. The Razor Blade does win with base damage and headshot damage. They have the same critical hit chance and critical hit damage. The fire rate is higher on the Gamatron, and that's going to be important at 8.8 on the Razor Blade. Magazine size, again, higher on the Gamatron. And the magazine size is over here at 30. You can see down here that there is no magazine size on the Gamatron. Lastly, the range is the same at 40-96, and the reload time is slightly longer on the Gamatron with slightly less impact. Now, here's where the gun gets interesting. Every single one of these weapons, every single one, the Gamatron, the Blastatron, the Blastatron Mini, are all above average, with the Blastatron Mini being slightly better than most. The rest of the weapons are just slightly above average, or just slightly power creep something that's already in the game, like this. The guns are so similar, so similar that it's actually really hard to tell the difference in damage. Max level, which is the footage that you guys are going to see, I believe there's about a 10,000 damage difference per bullet. But let's talk about exactly how you can roll this thing. If you guys like this kind of weapon, let's take a further look, and of course you know how we're going to roll it anyway, but let's just get it out of the way in case somebody is new. So let's talk about the sixth perk of the Gamatron before we get into actually how you might want to roll it, because let's be honest, you probably already know that information. There's six perks. You have three to choose from, or three that you can get or keep looking for. Is eliminating an enemy creates an expanding ring of damage. This is probably the worst one. The ring really does not hit that very hard, and once you're doing higher level content, it becomes pretty bad. The second one that you might want to keep an eye out for is the thing blows up and it gives a projectiles of like seven things spawn, each one doing damage. Now, originally I thought that this blew up propanes, and a lot of people say that it does. I've yet to have it blow up any kind of propane ever, so I don't know, but in my opinion it doesn't. The last one, and probably the one you're looking for, is going to be crit rating 1.8 per 1 second, up stacks up to 15. That's probably the best one. That's probably the best one for many of these weapons, unless you're trying some weird funky AoE build, which we're going to talk about in another video coming really soon. So you're going to be looking for that crit rating perk, as it just adds as much DPS as possible, and the other two perks are subpar at best. So how are you going to want to roll this gun? Real easy: energy, crit rating, reload speed, or magazine size, depending on what build you're going for. Reload speed on a specific build is nuts. It's absolutely insane. Your uptime is through the roof, but if you cannot replicate that build, then you're probably going to want to go to magazine size here. This one's going to be crit damage, and this one's going to be crit damage. I'm sorry, crit rating here, crit damage here, crit damage here. They always change them. So you want double crit damage and one crit rating with a reload or magazine size, depending on what heroes you have available. Now, this is where things get a little different. I'm not going to go over Sledgehammer. If you've been following this channel or any Save the World YouTube channel at all, you know he's probably top... one of the top soldiers in the game, probably top two in the entire game. He's probably one of the best soldiers. So we're going to switch this and twist the conversation a little bit to something slightly different. Now, in this game, there are two different kinds of damage. There's burst damage and sustained damage. In my opinion, you should value burst damage more because things, even at max rank, sustained damage isn't a huge deal. Things don't live long enough for you to have 250 bullets in the clip and be hitting for 220k every single bullet. It's not necessary. When the game gets even harder than it is now, or new enemy types or super tanky enemies do spawn, yes, it's nice to have a lot of sustained damage. The best sustained damage you can get in the game is a combination of Nutcracker and Startup and some other perks that you can get. This is a burst damage build. This is the build that you would put reload speed on the Gamatron. And in this state, it works really, really well. Let's break down the perks. First, we have First Assault. After reloading assault weapons, the next six shots have a 100% critical chance. This is interesting. If you have a weapon that has the sixth perk of 1.8 crit chance per every six shots, then you are looking at a decent increase in crit chance by the time you even shoot. If you put one crit rating on the gun, it'll give you 38%. If you roll one crit rating, if you follow the video and put one crit rating on your weapon, you'll be at 38%. If you shoot those first six shots, which are guaranteed to crit, you will have at least about 10% extra crit rating afterwards. So you'd be at 38 plus 10.8, and you are looking at a total of almost 50% crit chance for the rest of the bullets you're basically going to shoot. Depending on how exactly the crit rating does work, I've heard two different schools of thoughts on this, and I tried to explain it in another cut of this video. I'm not going to get into it because it gets confusing. So let's take a look at the rest of the build. Preemptive Strike. Like I said, this is the burst build. This is for taking down enemies quickly and moving on to a new target. You do lose out here if you have to kill something super tanky, but it still does a very decent job at doing damage. We're going to have Preemptive Strike because we're trying to kill things as fast as possible, and this is 6.5 times 5, which ends up being a lot of bonus damage for that first bullet. We're going to talk about Locked and Reloaded and In a Pinch. I haven't mentioned this in actually a few videos, and it's still just as strong as it ever was. Locked and Reloaded gives you a base 15% base damage for 5 seconds, and In a Pinch gives you a shield plus reload speed. I know it doesn't say it, but it does. I promise you it does. And she's coming out real soon, so you guys can finally try this out if you don't have a voucher for her. And when we did the math, it adds about, I think, 33% extra damage to your gun total because of the less downtime with the reload. Assault crit damage, assault damage. And now we have Startup here, which is not 100% necessary, but at least it lets you keep up with your damage. You have plenty of bullets to do so. It lets you keep up with the damage to get the full 25 stacks. Now, I just did a quick little search on YouTube, and every single YouTube video that I found about the Gamatron 9000 uses Sledgehammer. Now, granted, I didn't go through every single one, but every one that I saw uses Sledgehammer, and I didn't want to do that, so we're going to talk about Rex. Now, the difference here is minimal. Very minimal to what we showed with Rio. Rio might not be the absolute best build, but it's a nice little niche build you might want to try. I've covered Sledgehammer 600 times already. You know how to build him. But the Rex build is so similar, it's only like a 10,000 damage DPS loss, which is really, really good. And that brings us to the last point of this video. These weapons, every single one of them, except maybe the pistol, is well above average. But average just the same. There's nothing wrong with any of these guns. They all do great damage. The Gamatron 9000 is actually one of the most accurate assault rifles in the entire game, so that has that going for it. Energy cells no longer are going to cost bacon very, very soon, and you can use this gun in every single scenario because it is guaranteed to be energy. All of these things combined create a fantastic weapon, especially for new players. If you're a new player, you don't have to deal with the BS we had to deal with leveling up guns back in the day, only getting them from llamas. You can grab this event llama, get any weapon in the game, and you're set to go through the majority of the game. Rex, Sledgehammer, Rio, Urban Assault, all of them work really, really well with this weapon because it's so well-rounded. It's like a jack-of-all-trades assault rifle. Not really fantastic at anything, but really good at everything. So check it out, the Gamatron 9000. I highly recommend it, especially if you're new to the game. So make sure to grind those tickets and get this weapon. Like I said, if you're new, it's going to be one of the best weapons you can pick up. It probably replaces many of the weapons you have played with before, as it does a lot of damage, is accurate as hell, and works on any hero you want, even if you don't want to make a specific build for it. Constructors, Outlanders, and Ninjas included here, because of how well-rounded the weapon is, it's going to work no matter what. Thank you guys so much for watching and all of the support you guys show. If you're new to this channel, feel free to subscribe. I post videos like this and Trap Tunnel guides about 5 times a week. We would love to have you as part of the pack. If you are looking to support the channel in other ways, feel free to use my creator code OOTICTACOO. Lastly, if you like streams, I stream about 5 days a week at twitch.tv/roundedticktack. Come stop by, meet the family, meet the crew, meet the pack. I'll see you guys on the next one. Tic Tac out.